We are again back with the daily current affairs for CDS NDA AFCAT INET. Today's date is 19th June 2020. This channel is Military Inc. sponsored by SSB Shoshot Academy. So ladies and gentlemen, as you all know that SSB Shoshot Academy is always toward nation building, and in that cause they have many online courses for the SSB, for personal development course and English speaking course and stage 1 and GTO. Then we have psych test and personal interview, after which we have also written exam course, that is 45 day NDA course, 45 day CDS course, 40 day extensive AFCAT course. So without wasting any time, get to the SSB Shoshot Academy, choose the right course for you, start preparing and achieve what you dream for. Now gentlemen, today Sustainable Gastronomy Day 2020 is celebrated on June 18th. June 18th of every year is observed as the Sustainable Gastronomy Day to celebrate seasonal ingredient and producers, preserve wildlife and culinary traditions. Now the next news is that the NASA scientists observed Bose-Einstein quantum fifth state of matter in space for the first time. On June 11, 2020, according to the research published in the journal Nature, a team of scientists at NASA, National Aeronautics and Space Administration's Cold Atom Lab, CAL, have found for the first time in space the evidence of fifth state of matter known as Bose-Einstein condensate. Now this special state of matter occurs when the atoms of some elements are cooled to absolute zero. And ladies and gentlemen, Kubatbek Boronov appointed as Kyrgyzstan Prime Minister. Now on June 17, 2020, Kubatbek Boronov, 55 years old, was appointed as Kyrgyzstan Prime Minister. Kyrgyzstan's President Sooronbay Jeenbekov signed an order to appoint him. He succeeded Mukhamedkaliy Abelgaziev, who resigned on June 15 following accusations of corruption. The next news is that the Volkan Bozkir becomes the first Turkish to be elected as the president of 75th UN General Assembly. Volkan Bozkir from Turkey was elected as the president of the 75th United Nations General Assembly. He is the first Turkish to hold this post. He will hold the post for 1 year. Volkan Bozkir will succeed Tijani Muhammad Bande when the annual session opens on September 15, 2020. He won unopposed with the support of 178 UN members, state by secret ballot. And the next news is that the Karnataka Bank launches health insurance policy to cover COVID-19 in partnership with Universal Sompo General Insurance Company. Now, Karnataka Bank, in partnership with Universal Sompo General Insurance Company, has launched a health insurance policy. The policy aims to cover the individual's COVID-19 pandemic related health expenses. The health cover can be availed at a nominal premium of ₹399 inclusive of all taxes. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next news is that the ICICI Home Finance launches SARL Affordable Housing Loan Scheme. ICICI Home Finance Company Limited launched SARL, a special affordable housing loan scheme to finance homes in urban and rural areas. The beneficiaries are women, lower middle income customers, and economically weaker sections with a maximum household income up to ₹6 lakh per annum. The loan requires compulsory ownership of a woman in the country's rural areas from 3 lakh to 6 lakh. Now the next news that the RBI proposes new rules for housing finance companies, increases minimum not to ₹20 crore. On June 17, 2020, RBI, being a new regulator of housing finance company HFCs, has proposed changes to be prescribed for HFCs with an aim to increase their efficiency and address concerns of liquidity and double financing. Non-deposit ND taking HFCs, HFC ND with asset size of ₹500 crore and above, and all deposit taking HFCs, irrespective of asset size, will be treated as systematically important HFCs. Housing loan must account for at least 50% of HFCs assets, of which at least 75% should be towards individual housing loans. HFCs which do not fulfill this criteria will be treated as NBFC, investment and credit companies, NBFC, ICICs. So ladies and gentlemen, the next news is that India elected for 8th term as non-permanent member of UN Security Council for 2021 to 2022. India was elected unopposed for an 8th term as a non-permanent member of the United Nations Security Council for 2 years, starting January 2021 by gaining 184 votes in the 193 member General Assembly. Now India was the only candidate for the lone seat from the Asia Pacific category. India has previously been elected as a non-permanent member of the Council for the years 1950, 51, 67 to 68, 1970 to 73, 1977 to 1978, 1984 to 1985, 1991 to 1992, and most recently in 2011 and 12. Ladies and gentlemen, the formal jobs in India increased by 28.6% to 78.58 lakh in 2019 to 2020 EPFO. Now, according to the payroll data of EPFO, that is Employment Provident Fund Organization, the formal employment in India saw an 28.6% increase at 78.58 lakh in 2019-20 as compared to only 61.12 lakh added in 2018-19. The main reason for this is the low withdrawal by EPFO subscribers due to the government's policy reforms such as implementing GST, allowing fixed income contracts as well as better returns on PF deposits. So, ladies and gentlemen, as we have reached to the end of this today's session, so I have concluded all the stories from the national and international arena. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please like the press button. Also subscribe this channel, that is Military Inc., and also share as much as you can. So please help us to reach out to many young minds, because as we see from the past day that the Air Force Selection Board is going to start from 27th of July for the AFCAT 1 2020, and in the same time the TGC and SSC tech entries have already opened for the army. So because SSBs are lined up, you know, with a very short notice, so please be prepared and brush up your current affairs and stay tuned with us. We will be back tomorrow again to have some good news. So thank you, have a nice day.